Calgary, Alberta is home to renowned museums full of extraordinary artifacts with secrets just waiting to be discovered.
I think it's really important that when we move forward into the future, we have a good grounding in the past. Music has been passed on from generation to generation.
You may not know it by its name, but you know it by its sound. Is this 50-year-old holy grail of synthesizers still musically relevant today? And could it possibly have a mind of its own? More than a music museum, Studio Bell, home of the National Music Center, is a hub for musical and cultural discovery.
My name is Jason Talkin, and I'm the manager of Building Audio. We have a collection of artifacts from 450 years of music technology. What's different about our collecting institution is that we actually use those artifacts. TONTO is one of our most unique musical instruments. The name is an acronym. It stands for the Original New Timbral Orchestra. As musicians, we really love to interact with something that has some feeling to it and something that responds to us. So it's kind of got a mind of its own or a personality.
One of the mad scientists behind the electric monster that is TONTO is Malcolm Cecil, creating the first combination of synth technology in one machine to allow musical experimentation unlike ever before.
And they met at a studio in New York and began working together on a project called TONTO's Expanding Headband. They found a label to release this record, and one day they were working together in the studio and there was a knock at the door, and it was Stevie Wonder, and he had TONTO's Expanding Headband record, and he said, "I want to see TONTO." And that day they recorded like 5 or 6 songs.
Arguably the most famous sounds made by TONTO are from Stevie Wonder's Superstition.
Superstition has a bass line, and that is all TONTO. So you have Stevie on the actual keys playing the melodies, but Robert and Malcolm were actually manipulating the controls of the instrument in real time. And that's where really what set off this whole electronic music craze. Bands like the Isley Brothers and Gil Scott-Heron and even Quincy Jones and the Doobie Brothers all wanted TONTO to be a part of their music.
But when the spotlight dims, where does the biggest, baddest synthesizer of all time go to continue its legacy? And just how did TONTO come to be at the National Music Center?
After 46 years of maintaining the instrument, Malcolm was looking for a home for the instrument. Yale wanted it. The Smithsonian wanted it. I think for Malcolm, we were at the perfect balance of telling the story of TONTO, but also maintaining it in its original shape so that it could be used as originally built.
This instrument can be of great value to future generations. I wanted to make sure that TONTO is preserved for history and not just as something to look at.
Since it's been restored, we've had a lot of different artists use it. We just had Tribe Called Red come in and use the instrument on their latest recording.
This is one of those quick hit record while we got the sound.
TONTO shows no signs of retiring as the secrets behind its intricate systems are passed down to a new generation of musicians who continue to experiment and create. Like a member of the band, it adds its own unique personality to modern music. Experience the mysteries of TONTO and thousands of other instruments for yourself at Studio Bell, home of the National Music Center.